state whether the following statements are true or false. Number one, magnetism is a force which can travel over a very large distance. This statement is false because it can work only over a relatively smaller distance. Number two, headphones are used both permanent magnets and electromagnets. This is true statement. On a magnetic field, the diagram, the arrows always run from the south pole to the north pole. This is false statement. They run from north pole to south pole. Four, all the materials are magnetic because all the material contain atoms and molecules. This is false statement. Five, a piece of steel can be magnetized by stroking it with a permanent magnet. This is true statement. Question number two, choose the correct option. Number one, what shape is the magnetic field around a wire carrying an electric current? Option A, circular. B, elliptical. C, square. D, the same as that around a bar magnet. The correct option is A, circular. Second statement, what happens to the magnetic field around a wire when the current in the wire is reversed? Option A, it is lost permanently. B, it is lost temporarily. C, it is reversed. D, it stays the same. The correct option is, it is reversed. Third, what happens to the magnetic field around a wire when the current flowing through the wire is increased? Option A, it disappears. B, it gets stronger. C, it gets weaker. D, nothing happens. The correct statement is B, it gets stronger. Fourth statement, where might a relay be used? Option A, in a car ignition system. B, in a loudspeaker. C, in a scrapyard. D, in an electric cooker. The correct option is A, in a car ignition system. Fifth statement, what is the difference between an electromagnet and a permanent bar magnet? Option A, electromagnets are stronger. B, electromagnets are weaker. C, electromagnets can be turned on and off. D, electromagnets cannot be turned on and off. Correct option is C, electromagnets can be turned on and off. Question number three. The diagram shows a bar magnet having its north pole and south pole. We have to answer, why are the poles of a magnet called north and south? Beta, its answer is on page number 49. We know that earth affects the magnet, and if a bar magnet is hanged from a thread, it points roughly towards north and south. The end of the magnet which points towards the north is called north seeking pole, and the end of the magnet that points towards the south is called south seeking pole. 2. Which pole of a magnet A attracts the north pole? But a south pole of the magnet will attract the north pole. B, repels the south pole. South pole of a magnet will repel the south pole. Third, on the diagram above, draw lines to show the magnetic field of a bar magnet. Beta, you have to draw the magnetic field around this bar magnet, and it has been shown in this diagram like this. 4. Which of these materials are magnetic underlying the magnetic material? brass handle, newspaper, plastic cup, steel nail, copper wire, iron gate. Beta, you know that magnet can attract iron and steel among these substances. So steel nail and iron gate are our answers. Question number 4. A bar magnet drops to the floor and breaks in half. The two halves become complete magnets. Next we have to do label the poles of the new magnets. Beta, this is the north pole, then and this will be the south pole. And this is south pole, here will be the north pole. What will happen if the two new magnets are moved closer together? If these two magnets are moved closer together, they will attract each other because here they have opposite poles and unlike poles attract each other. What would happen if the magnets were broken into smaller and smaller pieces? If the magnets were broken into smaller and smaller pieces, each piece has its own north and south pole and it becomes a complete magnet. Question number 5. Use these words to fill the gaps in the passage. Demagnetized, domains, iron, magnetized, permanent, position, stroke. We can think of magnetic material as containing molecular magnets. Inside a magnetic material like iron, the molecular magnets line up in groups called domains. When a piece of magnetic material is stroked repeatedly with a permanent magnet, the molecular magnets start to line up. The iron becomes magnetized. A magnet can be demagnetized by heating it up and then quickly cooling it down. When this happens, the molecular magnets move about and change their position. Thank you.